Hello everyone, Habibi here. In this video, I'm going to continue my tutorial series about this Unity third-person controller system. I have this playlist link here. You can check out the link in the description of this video. You can watch all the videos related to this topic, making third-person game in Unity. And if you are not going to follow the tutorials and you want the complete package that I have made in these videos, you can purchase it here on the creativeshop.jihui.com. Here is the product and I will put the link in the description of this video. Today in this video, I'm going to add a pickup object capability to this game. For example, I want to create a gun object, and if the player reach the gun object, it will pick it up, and the gun will be listed on the weapon list that I has here. Right now it has only one weapon, which is punch. And here, let's get started to create a new object that is pickable. I will add an empty object here. I call it gun, and I will need a tag. I'm going to create a tag. I call it pickable, and then I set the tag of this game object as pickable. Yeah, I think I need to write it in uppercase P, pickable. It is not important, but yeah, I cannot type it twice. I don't know. I should type it in uppercase P like this. All right. I prefer this one because any other tags are in uppercase character at the first letter. And let me delete this one. Okay, so I have this game object with with this tag pickable. And I will add a box collider, and this box collider I will set it as trigger, and let me position it somewhere in the scene like this. And inside this gun pickable object, I will create a gun mesh. Let's say this is a gun mesh, and let me scale it down. No, let me create an empty object, gun mesh, and delete this one, and I will add a cube. You can skip this process if you already have a gun mesh already, and this is just a dummy 3D object as a gun. Let's say this is my gun, and I'm going to place it inside this gun pickable object, and let me rename it to gun pickable, and I place it here inside it, and I set the position all the 3000 and here. Right now I have no weapons instead of just punch weapon. And hang on. Sorry guys, I'm going to rename it again to gun. Just gun. And then what is next? The next is I will add inside this myplayer.cs script on this onTriggerEnter function. Here I will do the if statement again here. If call the tag equals to a pick cable, then game data here, game data dot weapons, I will push a new weapon, I will add a new weapon, and the name of the weapon is the call dot game object, call dot game object dot name, and then after picking up the gun, I'm going to destroy the existing gun pickable object here. And if I'm correct, to destroy the game object, we can just call destroy and call the game object. Or I don't know if I want to check it on Google how to destroy game object in Unity, object.destroy. Okay, so to destroy it, yeah, we can call this method destroy game object, destroy call dot game object. Let's try it. Okay, one more thing, I need to update this update debug text. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that I have done some modification to the codes. Let me show you. I've done some modification on these scripts. Mostly are same, but in case the code is different, you can check out for the this one. I did not modify anything, and this is same also. This one I did some modification. I have this variable is jumping. In case the code is different, you can modify it also according to my script here. This is new code, and also it is mostly same, and this one is also has some modification. You can check it out. I can scroll it slowly. If you want to follow, you can pause the video and check it out. Okay, and also my rotation touchpad, I did not modify too much, and mostly it is same as before. Okay, let me continue with this one. Update debug text function is new one. It will update the text of the, where is the function? Hang on. Okay, this is the method. update the bug text, it will update the text that we have here on the top of the game, this text. So I will call this function here in after I pick up an object, so I can see that I've already picked up a new object. Let me refresh the game. I have one weapon, which is punch. Now let me go to this gun and let me pick it up. Now I have gun here. Oh yeah, one more thing that I forgot to save the game data. We need to save it, because if we don't save it, if we stop the game and we start it again, we lose the gun here. So we need to copy and paste that function, save game data, and we can try it again. Let's pick up the gun. Now I have the gun here. Okay. The next thing that I'm going to show you is how to hide this game object, because we have already picked up the gun, it shouldn't be here. So I don't want to pick it up again like this. I have multiple gun here. So the thing that we can do to hide the gun, we need to add a condition here at the start of this script. We will scan what are the pickable objects available on the scene, and we check, is that object, do we have it or not? If we have it, don't show that object. That is the idea. So here I'm going to do a loop. I will use the game object find game object by tags. Let me Google it. Unity find game objects with tag. Game object dot find game object with tags. Okay, we need to run this for each function. No. Okay. Maybe this one. We need to do the for each loop here. Game objects, I name it pickables. Game object pickables. Then pickables equals to game object find game objects with tag. Pickables equals to game object dot find game objects with tag. What is the tag? The tag is pickable. So I paste it here. Then we do the for each loop. We do this for each loop. Let me copy it first. For each game objects go in pickables. Vector 3D. Okay, let's remove these lines. We don't need it. Here we do the loop again inside this for each loop. I will need to create a new function, public void or public boolean. Public bool. Do I have what? Do I have a game object with this name? And here the parameter should be string pname, pickable name or object name or name. Yeah, Here we will do the for loop. For integer I equals to 0, I less than, same as what we did here, gamedata.weapons.count, gamedata.weapons.count, and I plus plus. Here, if we do the if statement, if object name equals to gamedata.weapons index I, then what will happen? We will return true. Yes, we have the object. Else, if we don't the object that we have that we did in loop, that we search in loop, then what will happen? We will return false. No, we don't have it. So I will call this boolean function here, boolean method. I will call it here. Do I have go dot name? Here should be if function. If do I have go dot name, then just destroy that game object. Destroy that go, the game object. Okay, let's try the to run the game. There is my gun pickable object. Then because I already have the gun, it should not be here anymore. You see, the gun is gone. Until now we did the necessary things for this mechanism for picking up an object. So, and this object is also duplicatable, so we can duplicate it. For example, we can duplicate it here and we name it another gun. If we hit the play button, we will see that one because we did not pick it, but we did not we but we don't see the first one because we already have it. Now if we pick it, if we pick it up, it will be gone and we have another gun here. And if we stop the game and start it again, we will not see those weapons anymore there. Okay, that's all for this video, and see you next time on my next videos. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to hit like button, subscribe to my channel to support me, and you can support me by purchasing my assets on my website. Thank you, see you next time.